Vitamin C is a water soluble vitamin. It's also called as ascorbic acid. It is water soluble. So vitamin C, which is also called as ascorbic acid, is a water soluble vitamin. It is present in the form of D-ascorbic acid, L-ascorbic acid, and dehydroascorbic acid. D-ascorbic acid has only 1/20th potency of L-ascorbic acid. These two are both having the same potency, same potential. Okay, chemically if we see, vitamin C is a 6-carbon moiety. It has enediol groups and it acts as a strong reducing agent. So vitamin C, ascorbic acid in three forms: D-ascorbic acid, L-ascorbic acid, and dehydroascorbic acid. D-ascorbic acid has only 1/20th potency. L-ascorbic acid and dehydroascorbic acid have the same potential. Chemically, it is a 6-carbon moiety, which has enediol groups, and therefore it is a strong reducing agent. Now, in humans, ascorbic acid cannot be produced or vitamin C cannot be produced because humans lack the enzyme glutenolactone dehydrogenase. If we remember, this enzyme is present in uronic acid cycle, and because we do not have this enzyme, therefore vitamin C cannot be produced by humans. Okay. Coming to the dietary source, it is present in all citrus fruits, gooseberry, amla, it is present in all citrus fruits, plus it is present in potatoes and tomatoes. Milk is a very poor source of vitamin C. Now, vitamin C is a very wonderful vitamin because it is thought to cure everything from common cold to cancer. So, many researches are going on vitamin C, and recommended dietary allowance is 60 to 70 milligram per day. Okay? So, vitamin C can be produced not by humans because we lack glutenolactone dehydrogenase, which is an enzyme in the uronic acid pathway. The dietary source is present in all citrus fruits, potatoes and tomatoes. Now coming to what is the most important biochemical role of vitamin C. So the most important biochemical role is the hydroxylation reactions. Wherever hydroxylation reaction takes place, vitamin C is present as a coenzyme. So it is present as a coenzyme in collagen synthesis, for lysyl oxidase and prolyl hydroxylase. So most important thing is collagen synthesis, and because vitamin C takes part in the formation of collagen synthesis. Collagen is a very important part of the connective tissue. So whenever vitamin C deficiency is present, there is deficient formation of collagen, and it will lead to the most important manifestation of vitamin C, that is scurvy. Now coming to the second point in hydroxylation, that is enzymes in carnitine synthesis. Third, it is the enzyme which converts dopamine to norepinephrine. That is dopamine monooxygenase. This reaction will also require vitamin C. Next, in tyrosine metabolism, next, in formation of peptide synthesis, peptide hormone synthesis by the enzyme peptidyl glycine hydroxylase. Six, it is also important in the bone formation. So the biochemical roles in these hydroxylation reactions, that is formation of collagen, the most important, carnitin synthesis, dopamine to norepinephrine, tyrosine metabolism, peptidyl hormone synthesis and bone formation. Now coming to the physiological roles of vitamin C. These were the biochemical roles taking part in all hydroxylation reactions that take place in the body. Coming to the physiological role first, it is more important in absorption of iron. So whenever vitamin C intake is increased, vitamin C is taken along with the food, there is increased absorption of iron. It converts the methemoglobin to hemoglobin. Next, it decreases the lipid peroxidation. Decreases the lipoprotein oxidation. So actually it is decreasing the VLDL. Decreases the lipid peroxidation, decreases the lipoprotein oxidation. So and the next important function is that it prevents the oxidative damage or decreases the oxidative damage to DNA or protein. The most important physiological function is that it is a strong antioxidant. This is the most important function. So it increases the absorption of iron. It converts the methemoglobin to hemoglobin, decreases the lipid peroxidation, decreases the lipoprotein oxidation, prevents or decreases the oxidative damage to DNA, and it is a strong antioxidant action. And because it is a strong antioxidant action, it has a sparing effect on antioxidants of like vitamin A, vitamin E. Therefore, it is also called a sparing antioxidant action. It also increases the endothelial dependent vasodilatation. So vitamin C has important biochemical reaction, is important as a coenzyme in hydroxylation reaction, and increase and is important physiological role is in the absorption of iron and decreasing of lipid peroxidation and lipoprotein oxidation. Now the deficiency of vitamin C, if at all vitamin C is not taken in a proper amount, and if there is deficiency of vitamin C, there will be decrease in collagen synthesis and it will lead to scurvy. So the deficiency of vitamin C causes scurvy. There are many studies going on that vitamin C can treat common cold, as well as vitamin C can intake of high amount of vitamin C can prevent cancers. And because people also believe that vitamin C is helpful in increasing collagen, helpful in collagen synthesis. So it is also given for in certain beauty treatments, it is prescribed so that people either topically apply vitamin C or either intake of vitamin C may help you to remain young. That's all for vitamin C. Thank you.